Word Magic and the Power of Words by Pao Chang EsotericKnowledge.me Omnithought.org. A word is defined as a sound or a combination of sounds, or its representation in writing or printing, that symbolizes and communicates a meaning and may consist of a single morpheme or of a combination of morphemes. As for magic, it is the art of directing and controlling energy using natural forces to produce a desired effect. When you put these two words together, you get the term word magic, which means the art of communicating using sacred sounds and symbols to direct and control energy to produce a desired effect. In simple terms, word magic is the art of using wordplay, phonics, anagram, sacred sounds, symbols, and metaphors to strengthen the intent of a word. Word magic is often used to hide the deeper meaning of a word to deceive us. However, if it is used in a positive way, it can empower us. The power of words and magic words are not just elements of speech or writing, because they can be used to strengthen the effects of magic. When spoken out loud, words transform into frequencies and vibrations that can be used to direct energy. This is one of the first steps to creating real magic. Most people will laugh at the idea of magic being real, but if only they knew what magic really is and how magic is being used to control them, they would not be laughing. Remember, magic is the art of directing and controlling energy using natural forces, i.e., sound, thought, to produce a desired effect. In other words, magic is the art of directing and controlling energy. What most of us do not understand about the reality of Earth is that we live in a world dominated by magic. Until you learn how magic works and how it is being used to control you, you will never know how the world really works. The most powerful thing in the universe is energy. If you learn how to control and direct this energy, you will become one of the most powerful people on Earth. This is why the controllers, the dark magicians, are so obsessed with magic and energy. The word magic comes from old French magique, Latin magicus, and Greek magikos. Magic has a strong relationship with magnetic and electrical energy. Did you notice that the word magnetic has the word magic in it? Take out net in magnetic and you are left with the word magic. The art of magic is often practiced along with certain words and sacred geometries. The types of words that are used in magic rituals are the words that produce powerful sound tones. When these words are spoken out loud, they produce sound tones with powerful vibrational patterns that can be used to direct energy and harness its power. Sound is able to direct energy because it contains certain frequency patterns that attract energy to flow in a controllable manner. Furthermore, sound is one of the natural forces used by nature to create sacred geometries, which are some of the building blocks of matter. If you have studied cymatics, you should know that sound and vibration can organize matter into sacred geometries. Cymatics is the study of sound and vibration made visible, typically on the surface of a plate, diaphragm, or membrane. Cymatics, sacred geometries formed by sound. Visit the link below to watch a short video on cymatics. This short video will show you visual evidence of the power of sound and how sound organizes matter into sacred geometries. https://www.youtube.com/watch?v=vfrtjz3nrqm Cymatics Experiment, Mozart's Una Donna a Quindiciani Cymatics Experiment using a homemade tonoscope. Click here to watch this fascinating short video. The two videos about cymatics that you just watched showed how the power of sound and frequency could be used to direct and control energy to produce sacred geometries. Like cymatics, words that are spoken out loud can direct and control energy, because they carry sound and frequency. Once you realize how powerful words are, you may agree with me that words can be as powerful or even more powerful than swords. When you move the letter S in the term words to the front, you get sword. This did not happen by accident. Nearly all words in the English language are carefully designed and put together in a way that produces magic effects, so that the creators of these words, which are the dark forces and their minions, can trick you to play their con game. By the end of this presentation, you will know exactly what that means. The birthing and commerce process. The words that are used to describe the birthing process are strongly related to commerce. Because of this, you need to know some information about merchants and the sea business, or you will have a hard time seeing the connection. If you have studied the information in my second seminar, you should have little problem understanding the birthing and commerce process. Before there were airplanes, automobiles, and trains, when one country wanted to send products to another country, they would often send them on a ship. Using ships to send goods to other countries became so important that many laws were created to protect merchants and their products. The two laws that dominated the sea business were Admiralty Law, the law of the sea, and Maritime Law, law merchant. Both of these laws originally heard cases involving commerce on the high seas. Today, nearly every courthouse in the United States, Canada, the United Kingdom, and certain Western and Eastern countries are operating under admiralty maritime law. This means that the courts in these countries are operating under military law and commercial law, and therefore when people go to court, they are treated as properties and war criminals. This is why when you mention your common law or constitutional rights in a U.S. courtroom, the judge may tell you to sit down and shut up. There is no justice in a court that operates under admiralty, maritime law. Let us turn our attention back to ships and merchants. When a ship reaches its destination, the captain orders his crew to prepare the ship to be docked. After the ship docks, the crew can start to unload the cargoes and products off the ship. A ship is also a vessel, so after a ship docks onto the shore, it is considered a berthed vessel. The word berthed is phonetically similar to the word berthed. Before the crew can unload all the cargoes and products off the ship and onto the dock, they have to first show a certificate of manifest. This manifest is a record that has information about the products, i.e., the registration number, the country of origin, the manufacturer, etc. The certificate of manifest is basically your birth certificate. On your birth certificate, there is a registration number, country of origin, and manufacturer. Metaphorically speaking, the manufacturers that created you, the product, are your parents. Unloading products from docked ships, the process of using ships to deliver products, is where the word shipping comes from. Did you notice that the word shipping has the word ship in it? When a ship is in the process of being docked, it is being guided to come to berth. The word berth is defined as a space for a vessel to dock or anchor. Based on this information, when a product is unloaded to the dock, it just went through the berthing process, which is the process of delivering the product from the vessel, ship, to the dock. The word berth phonetically sounds like birth. This is why when a woman is in the process of giving birth, she is said to be delivering a baby. Every woman has a body. Another word for body is vessel. A vessel can also be called a ship. The words body, vessel, and ship can all mean the same thing and be used to represent a woman's body. This is why a ship is often referred to as she, and the main ship is often referred to as the mother ship. When you transfer all the information that you have just learned about commerce and the sea business into the process of birthing a baby, you will see a strong connection between the birthing process of a ship and the birthing process of a baby. When you were in your mother's womb, you were surrounded in amniotic fluid, which was made of mostly water. In other words, you were living in a sea of water. Because you were living in water, according to admiralty law, the law of the sea, you could be ruled under this law. While living in your mother's womb, the thing that connected you to your mother was the umbilical cord, which was connected to your navel. Metaphorically speaking, you were connected to the mother ship. The word navel sounds similar to the word navy. The navy is the military of the sea. They did not name that area of your body the navel by accident. By now you should start to see how these words are all somehow related to the sea. On average, after conception, a fetus lives in the womb of its mother for a little more than 9 months before the fetus is ready to be birthed. When you were a fetus, you were living in water, amniotic fluid. Shortly after 9 months, you were born from your mother's body, vessel or ship, through her birth canal. The phrase birth canal sounds a lot like the phrase birth canal. A canal is an artificial waterway that is used by the captain of a ship or boat to birth his vessel. Hence, birth, birth canal. After you came out of your mother's birth canal, you were grabbed by the doctor. The word doctor is pronounced similar to dock or. The word dock is defined as a platform extending from a shore over water, used to secure, protect, and provide access to a boat or ship. The word ore is defined as a metal-bearing mineral or rock, or a native metal, that can be mined at a profit. The word ore also sounds similar to the word oar, which is a long shaft with a broad blade at one end, used as a lever for rowing or otherwise propelling or steering a boat. What you need to know about these words is that they all somehow relate to a ship, the sea, and the process of giving birth. To connect the dots, you, the baby, represents the ore because you are the battery that is being used as energy to power the matrix of the dark forces. So, when you were delivered from the mother ship onto the dock, you, the ore, was delivered onto the dock. Hence, the word doctor, doc or. This is why the person who delivers babies at a hospital is called a doctor. The doctor's or doc's doc role is to deliver the baby, or dock the ore onto the shore, so that it can be sold and used as energy. The word ore also sounds similar to the first syllable of the word aura. Aura is an energy field that is part of the bioelectromagnetic field of a natural person. When you split the word aura into two words, you get aura. The word O comes from the Latin word aurum, meaning gold. This is why in chemistry the symbol for gold is O. The word Ra is the name of an ancient god called Ra, pronounced Ray. In Egyptian mythology, Ra was the sun god who was often shown as a hawk. When you put the word sun and Ra together, you get sun Ra or sun Ray, which is connected to the sun god Ra. The human aura, O Ra, and the Egyptian sun god Ra, every ship or body ship, is brought into port and docked, so that the doctor can deliver, the body ship, because it is a new liver being produced or a new baby being delivered by the doctor as docked ore, the ore that is now docked and ready to be sold and used as energy. The dark forces view each of us like an ore, because we are the ore that is being mined for gold, O, through the process of mind control. The word mind is phonetically mind, giving us a clue as to why the Anunnaki came to Earth. One of the main reasons why they came to Earth was not to mind for gold but to mind for the gold in our minds, because to control our minds is to control the golden blood plasma in our bodies and the golden energy in our auras, which then can be used to extend their lifespans or charge the sun god Ra. Hence, the word aura, O Ra. In Greek mythology, the golden blood plasma is called Achor, a gold-colored fluid that is believed to be found in the blood of the alien gods, allowing them to live for thousands of years. It is my understanding that this golden plasma is found in very small amounts in the human body. However, during an ascension cycle, the human body can produce more of it. The special element that is found in the golden blood plasma is organic monoatomic gold, white powder gold. Organic monoatomic gold can only be created by our bodies and nature. It is not the same as the synthetic monoatomic gold that is being sold as a dietary supplement. It is important for you to know that at the deepest level the Earth drama is a spiritual war for your soul and energy. By the end of this presentation, you will know why the dark forces need your energy to survive. Let us turn our attention back to the birthing process. In the United States, shortly after you are born, a certificate of manifest is created with certain information about you recorded on it. This manifest is known as your certificate of live birth, which is not the same as your birth certificate. After your parents sign the certificate of live birth, the certificate is sent to the U.S. federal government. After the U.S. federal government is done doing whatever they need to do with your certificate of live birth, they send you a new version of your certificate of live birth, which is known as your birth certificate. Your new birth certificate is not the original certificate of live birth, because it is actually a death certificate. The term birth certificate sounds similar to birth certificate. This was deliberately done to trick you using the art of phonics, which is a method of teaching people to read and pronounce words by learning the sounds of letters, letter groups, and syllables. Phonetically, there is no difference between the terms birth certificate and birth certificate because they sound exactly the same. When they created the birth certificate, their intention was to trick your parents to sign your natural rights away and turn you into a product of a ship or vessel to be sold in commerce. Therefore, a birth certificate is a certificate of manifest for a product that has been birthed from a ship. In other words, mailing a copy of your birth certificate to your parents is the U.S. government's way of telling your parents that you're a product of the United States of America, Incorporated. This is why they trade your birth certificate on the stock market. Why do you think they use the word parents to describe your mother and father? The word parents sounds similar to parents, which means the pair that rents. When your parents, sign your birth certificate, they unknowingly agree to allow the U.S. federal government to partially own you and make you a product of the USA, Incorporated. This means that your body and everything that you buy or produce are legally the properties of the U.S. federal government. However, your parents are allowed to keep or rent you as long as they pay taxes and take decent care of the new product, baby, you. If you have studied my seminar about natural law, you should know that when the U.S. government refers to the United States of America, most of the time they are talking about the corporation called the United States of America, Inc. Also doing business as the United States, Inc. or the United States of America, Minor. The continental United States, the landmass, is often called the United States of America, Major. It is not a part of the United States of America, Incorporated. From the perspective of Americans, the United States of America, Inc. is actually a foreign corporation that resides in Washington, D.C., which is also a foreign corporation. Why do you think the United States has a president and a vice president? Corporate law requires a corporation to have a president and a vice president. The acronym D.C. stands for the District of Columbia, which is a 10-mile radius district. So, when they talk about the United States, Inc., they are referring to the District of Columbia and not the landmass. This district was founded by a powerful Masonic secret society called the Colombians. The Colombians also founded Columbia Broadcasting System, CBS, Columbia Pictures, and Columbia University. Did you notice how similar the words Colombians and Columbia are? One thing you should know about Columbia University is that it is located in New York. New York was founded by the York Rite, which is also another powerful, since you know now that there are two main versions of the USA and that the corporate version is the one they like to use the most. Let us dig deeper into the birthing process, so that you can learn how they used word play and word magic to trick you to give up your natural rights. Masonic Secret Society. This is why it is called New York, which means the new city of the York Rite. Columbia University, before the invention of computers, when people were born, they would publish their birth information in the newspaper. Nowadays, because of computers and the internet, they rarely publish birth information in newspaper. Instead, they publish it on certain government-sponsored websites. Shortly after you were born, the doctor extracted blood from the bottom of your foot, which is known as the sole of your foot. Keep in mind that the word soul sounds similar to the word soul. Most doctors do not know the real reason behind this procedure, so if your parents were to ask them why they do this, they would most likely tell your parents that they extracted your blood to test it for genetic conditions and diseases. Besides extracting your blood, they also took tissue samples and blood from your mother's placenta. The purpose of taking your blood is to extract your DNA from it. Your blood has DNA in it, and therefore it allows the government to sequence your DNA to determine your genetic blueprint. Your genetic blueprint is like your fingerprint, because no one else has that same genetic blueprint. Because of this, your DNA is the physical proof of evidence that the government can use to identify you. Once the government is done sequencing your DNA and creating your personal file, they often announce your birth information on some of the websites that they sponsored. What they are basically doing is telling the public that they found parts of you and someone needs to claim them. It is like a lost and found service. If no one claims them after a certain amount of time, usually 7 years, then the government has the legal right to pronounce you as legally dead. The problem with this process is that the government did not tell your parents that they need to claim those parts of you, and therefore the government is basically committing fraud. Be aware that when the government announces you as being legally dead, it does not always mean that you, the living person, are really dead. You can be alive and still be named legally dead. Under Admiralty law, if you are missing for 7 years, you can be declared legally dead. This is why people lost at sea are declared legally dead after 7 years. In the USA, the political and court system are operating under Admiralty, maritime law. Both of these laws deal with commerce on the sea. So, when the US government announces you as being legally dead, what they are really saying is that you are dead at sea. They say this because you are mostly made of water and you were born from a sack of water, the amniotic sac. Because you are legally dead and the government owns your legal name, the government can legally claim your estate. This process is similar to when people die and their estates are transferred to the people listed on their wills. The legal name process. Your legal name is the corporate name that the government uses to identify you. Most of us have been conditioned to think that our legal names are actually who we are. In reality, our legal names are not who we are, because each of us is a man or a woman with a body made of flesh and blood. Names are not real, breathing people, but instead are symbols of things, non-beings. In legal term, names are artificial persons, which are corporations. Because corporations are artificial persons, they can be pretty much anything. For example, religious institutions, banks, names, and the government are all corporations because they are fictitious entities. Shortly after you were born, your parents gave you a name. They gave you or you a name because you are going to be a good little sheep for the controllers. Did you know that the word you is defined as a female sheep and is pronounced similar to the word you? The controllers like to call you a sheep or sheeple because sheep are some of the dumbest animals on the planet and they are great at following orders. Why did your parents give you a name? Because a name is a name, which is a sound that a horse likes to make. Besides calling you a sheep, the controllers, the dark magicians, also like to call you a horse, because a horse is phonetically horse. If you think this is just a coincidence, you have no idea how deep the horse connection goes. When a couple have relationship problems and are constantly arguing, they are sometimes described as nagging each other. A nag is an old, inferior, or worthless horse. If they argue and nag at each other for too long, their voices may eventually sound hoarse. The word horse sounds similar to the word horse. Maybe the relationship is not stable because the groom did not pony up enough courage to get a good job, or maybe they could not afford a baby crib. The word crib is simply an English synonym for pony. As for the word groom, it is defined as a man or boy in charge of horses or the stable. One of the major reasons why a couple argues is because they do not know how to manage their time. Etymologically, the word manage is derived from the Italian word managere, which means to handle, especially to control a horse. What about a ponytail? Sometimes a man does not like it when his woman puts her hair in a ponytail, or maybe his woman does not have nice bangs. Bangs usually do not cause too many relationship issues, so her bangs should not be the main problem. Oh, I know. Maybe the man does not like to bang his woman anymore. When the English word bangs is translated into German, it means pony, fringe, bangs. Do you still think the horse-horse connection is just a coincidence? We have barely scratched the surface of the horse connection. In commerce, when you see a name written in all capital letters, it is a corporate name or a legal name, which is a corporation. The legal name plays a significant role in your life, because it is used by the government to identify the corporate you. Whenever you receive a government document issued to you, 99% of the time your legal name on the document is written in all caps. This is why your legal name on your driver's license, social security card, and birth certificate is written in all caps. The process that allows the government to legally claim you as a corporation involves the creation of a fictional you, which is the name written in all capital letters, and then tricking you to agree to be that artificial person or legal name. This legal name was created shortly after you were born and was recorded on a bond. This bond that represents the date of your birth is known as your birth certificate. The birth certificate is actually a certificate of debt slavery, which is why it is recorded on a bond. Thelawdictionary.org defines bond as a contract by specialty to pay a certain sum of money, being a deed or instrument under seal, by which the maker or obligor promises, and thereto binds himself, his heirs, executors, and administrators, to pay a designated sum of money to another. Your legal name, which is used to identify you, the body of water or liquid, is written in all capital letters because it is a piece of liquidated capital or capital. In other words, it has been securitized and turned into a financial instrument. Hence, the term, liquidated capital. To liquidate something is to sell it off entirely, or sell it to pay off a debt. It is called liquidated capital because you, the person who has been securitized, were born in the womb of your mother, which was mostly made of water, liquid. You are also mostly made of water. Because you are mostly made of liquid and have been securitized, you are considered liquidated capital. The purpose of liquidating you is to turn you into capital money. The word capital comes from the Latin word capitalis, which means of the head, hence capital, chief, first. It also comes from another Latin word caput, which translates to English as head. When you really think about this process, you should know that the process of turning you into capital money or liquidated capital is their way of saying that you have a bounty on your head. Your birth certificate is the bond with your all caps legal name written on it, and therefore it is the financial document that has the value of the bounty on your head. This is why your birth certificate is traded on the stock market. In the Western world and many Eastern countries, each of us were born into the world with a bounty on our heads. This is because the federal government considers us as enemies of the state. According to Judge Dale, author of The Great American Adventure, The Secrets of America, if you live in the USA, the act that makes you an enemy of the US federal government is the Trading with the Enemy Act. Even though you are considered an enemy of the corporate government, it actually has no jurisdiction over you as a living man or woman. However, if you agree to be a citizen of your corporate government, then it has jurisdiction over you. The reason why the US government has jurisdiction over you when you become a United States citizen is because a United States citizen is an employee of the United States, which is actually a corporation. If you want proof of this, look at line 15, in Title 28 U.S. Code Section 3002 and you should see this sentence, United States, means, a federal corporation. The act that legally turned the USA into a corporation was the District of Columbia Organic Act of 1871. This act also changed the USA from a republic to a democracy. Democracy is one of the worst types of government. The word democracy comes from the word demos, which means common people. A group of common people can also be called a mob. The word crecy comes from the Latin word cratia, meaning power, might, rule. Based on these definitions, democracy means mob rule or people power. By now you should know that your legal name is a name of a corporation, which is why 99% of the time it is written in all caps. It is important to know that even when your name is not written in all caps, it could still represent a corporation. Once you understand this process, you should know that your legal name is often written in all caps because it has been incorporated and securitized, so that it can be used in commerce. Another reason why your legal name is often written in all capital letters on a government contract, such as your birth certificate, is because capital letters are more effective for creating magic spells. Your birth certificate is not just a record of birth, it is also a spiritual contract that is sealed with dark magic. This is why there are sigils, seals, on your birth certificate. U.S. birth certificate, California. The school process in USA, most of us start kindergarten around the age of 5. The word kindergarten originated from two German words kinder, meaning children, and garten, which translates to English as garden. Kindergarten literally means a garden of children. Now, why would they, the controllers of the New World Order, NWO, named the first official school class kindergarten? To understand why they did this, we need to turn our attention to the story of Adam and Eve and the Garden of Eden. According to the Bible, shortly after God created the heavens and the earth, he also created a garden and a man named Adam. This man was given dominion over the plants and animals in this garden, which was called the Garden of Eden. Shortly after creating Adam, God used one of Adam's ribs to create a woman named Eve to be Adam's companion. Before I reveal some very controversial information about Adam and Eve and the Garden of Eden, we need to look at the Bible verse Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 from the King James Bible. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth." Did you notice that the first seven words that God said was, "Let us make man in our image"? In this verse, the Bible is talking about more than one God. This is why the verse has the word "us" and "our" in it. When the Bible talks about God, it is not always talking about the supreme creator. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, the Bible is talking about the planetary gods or the alien gods that came from the void called outer space. It has been mentioned by some biblical scholars that the early version of the Bible verse Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 was changed from, "Then Elohim said, let us make man in our image," to, "Then God said, let us make man in our image." The word Elohim is a plural noun and is a Hebrew word that when translate to English, it means gods. According to Bill Donahue, Elohim means the divine male and female. Anunnaki, ancient god. According to ancient records, these alien gods came to visit Earth thousands of years ago. One of the alien races was called the Anunnaki. During the ancient times, some of these alien races were worshipped as gods. Even today, many secret societies still worship these alien gods. The aliens' god was said to come from the stars. One of the stars is called Sirius. The word Sirius is related to the Latin word Siri, which translates to English as Sirius, greater dog star. Some ufologists believe that the Greys came from the Sirius star system, while others believe they came from Zeta Reticuli. The Latin word for Grey is Canis. Phonetically, the Latin word Canis is Canis, meaning dog or dog star. The word Canis is related to the constellation Canis Major, which means the greater dog in Latin. It represents the bigger dog following the constellation Orion, which is known as the mythical hunter. Certain ancient civilizations believed that the stars were the physical manifestation of the different states of God. Hence, the term star god or sun god. When you spell the word god backwards, you get the word dog. Put the word dog in front of the word star and you get dog star. The information in the paragraph above tells us that the word god has a strong connection to the word dog and Sirius, the star system where many of the ancient alien gods came from. If you have studied the information in my third seminar, you should know that the Bible is a religious book filled with metaphors, allegories, codes, symbols, esoteric anagram, and parables. Because of these things, if you do not know how to decipher the codes in the Bible, you are not reading mostly truthful information but are reading mostly deceptive information. This is why the sentences in the Bible are called verses. A verse is defined as a single metrical line in a poetic composition, one line of poetry. One of the things about a poem is that it often has metaphors in it. If you read the Bible verse Matthew chapter 13 verses 34 to 35, you will find evidence that the Bible contains parables. All these things Jesus spoke to the multitude in parables, and without a parable he did not speak to them, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, "I will open my mouth in parables, I will utter things kept secret from the foundation of the world." Matthew chapter 13 verses 34 to 35. Since you know now that the Bible is a religious book filled with parables, let us turn our attention back to Adam and Eve and the Garden of Eden. When the Bible refers to Adam, it sometimes refers to the first atom, atomic particle. Adam is phonetically Atom. Atom represents the divine masculine energy. As for Eve, she represents the divine feminine energy. When the divine masculine energy is out of balance, it often manifests the obsession to create destructive things to nature, such as genetic engineering. The Garden of Eden is the garden where the alien gods created life using genetic engineering. According to the book titled The Cosmic Code by Zecharia Sitchin, one of the alien races came to Earth roughly 445,000 years ago. This alien race was the Anunnaki. It was believed by Zecharia Sitchin that the Anunnaki was one of the first alien races to tinker with the early human beings' DNA. Certain researchers of Zecharia Sitchin's work believed that the Anunnaki combined some of their DNA with some of the human test subjects and were able to successfully create a new human hybrid race, which eventually evolved to the humans of today. The idea that alien gods creating modern humans may sound crazy. However, in the last few decades, geneticists discovered that the human DNA contained foreign DNA that may not be from Earth. This could explain the famous missing link in human evolution. Some researchers of these alien gods suggested that human beings were also used as a food source. This makes me wonder if the Garden of Eden is actually the Garden of Eden. Besides, what else would they use a garden for? To grow food to eat, right? If this were the case, then Earth would be the Garden of Eden. Is there evidence that human beings are being used as food? I have not found irrefutable proof that human beings are being used as food, so I do not know if it is true. However, I have found some evidence that points toward that direction, and I do know that we are being used as batteries. Once we get to the court process, you will know what I mean when I say that we are being used as batteries. One of the things you need to know about the dark forces, groups of demonic thought forms, and the controllers is that they like to tell you what they are doing to you or are planning to do to you in movies and TV shows. In the movie Jupiter Ascending, 2015, there is a scene where Titus shows Jupiter a room filled with thousands of vials that contain youth serums. By drinking the youth serums, it allows Titus and his race to live for thousands of years. What was shocking about the serums was that they were made from harvesting hundreds of dead humans. Could this be the Ichor or the golden blood plasma that the Greeks used to talk about? The golden blood plasma, which is believed to have organic monoatomic gold in it, could be one of the main reasons why the dark forces and the controllers have been promoting the idea that alien gods will come save us or that the rapture event will take certain people back to God. Keep in mind that when a religion refers to God, it is not always talking about the supreme creator. A lot of the time, it is referring to the alien gods of good or evil. The word rapture is connected to the Latin word raptus, which means a carrying off, abduction, snatching away, rape. Therefore, the deeper meaning of the word rapture is snatching or abduction. Christians who believe that they will be raptured to heaven have been deceived by the dark forces. If the alien gods are after our golden blood plasma, then the ascension process that we are currently going through would be the best time to trick us to agree to be harvested from the Garden of Eden, eaten. They need to trick us because they need our consent. If they were to take us by force, they would violate the law of free will. To overcome the problem of violating our free will, the dark forces like to use spiritual contracts to trick us to give up some of our free will. If you had signed a spiritual contract or agreed to participate in a religious contract, i.e., baptism, you can void it at the spiritual level by saying that the contract is now null and void and the Supreme Creator is your witness. You also need to void it at the physical level. To do this, you need to learn how to nullify legal contracts. Understand ContractLawanduan.com is a great website that can help you do this. Keep in mind that the birth certificate is also a spiritual contract. If it is true that the human body can produce more organic monoatomic gold during ascension cycles, then it would make sense that the alien gods would want to use the ascension process to trick human beings to agree to go with them. Maybe this is why ascension is sometimes called the harvest, as stated in the book titled The Raw Material. A word that gives us a clue to back up the harvesting of humans is the word fetus. Phonetically, the word fetus sounds like the term fetus. After the fetus is born, he or she is called a baby. The word baby is phonetically baby. The word bay is defined as a body of water partially enclosed by land but with a wide mouth, affording access to the sea. Because you are made of water, you are like the bay. As for the word bee, it is a name used to identify flying insects that are known for producing honey. Based on the two definitions above, the word baby means a body of water that produces honey. Combine water and honey and you get the golden blood plasma that the alien gods need for longevity. More babies mean more golden blood plasma or honey for the alien gods. Why do you think a couple in a relationship called each other honey or baby? Because every human or baby, fetus has golden blood plasma or honey inside him or her. To connect the dots, when you are old enough to go to kindergarten, garden of children, you the baby are put into a shelter constructed for housing a colony, also known as a hive. This shelter is used to school you to be a good little slave, so that when you grow in kindergarten, one of the first things they teach you is the alphabet, which is made of letters designed using sacred geometry. These letters are ideograms, which are written symbols that represent ideas. One important thing you need to know about all written symbols is that they are created into existence from the egg, the dot, and the serpent, the line. The egg and the serpent are important symbols in the religion of secret society. Up to be an adult, you are ready to work like a honeybee and produce golden plasma for the alien gods of the dark forces. After learning the alphabet, you are taught how to spell using the letters of the alphabet. This is to prepare you for the day you can cast magic spells through the use of spelling. Did you notice the term magic spell and the word spelling have the word spell in them? This is not an accident. It is right in your face. The hidden intent of spelling is to cast magic spells. Besides teaching you how to spell, you are also taught how to say the alphabet. This process is important for creating the right sound for each alphabet, which is essential for casting magic spells. When you speak, you are not just uttering words but also casting your thoughts and vibrations into Earth's magnetic field or magic field, which is the energy field that creates the reality of Earth. If you are not careful and say certain words together, you can actually cast a spell without even knowing it. Most of us do not know how magic works because we lack the knowledge to understand energy mechanics and sacred geometry. Because of this, we have no idea what we are actually doing when we yell harsh words at one another using swear words or curse words. They did not call them curse words for no reason. Are you starting to see the connection here? Why do you think most parents tell their kids to stop cursing when they swear too much? Even at a subconscious level, we intuitively know that it is not good to use curse words too much. When you utter curse words at people, you are casting dark magic spells on them. This is why you should be careful what you wish for. The main reason why you are taught how to spell words correctly in kindergarten is to make sure that each letter or geometry is arranged the same way every time you write something. This will help strengthen the magic effects of certain words. After learning how to spell words correctly, you are taught to cast those spellings into sentences and phrases without teaching you about the magic effects of spelling. The purpose of this is to prevent you from knowing the true intention of language, so that the controllers, the dark magicians, can control your mind using magic spells. Their magic spells cannot control 100% of your mind, but they do affect your mind more than you may realize, just like how subliminal messages can affect your subconscious to a large degree. By now you should know what I mean when I said earlier that nearly every word in the English language are carefully designed and put together by the minions of the dark magicians to trick you to play their con game. Most other languages are also created for this purpose. The magic effect of words is the main reason why words are so effective for deceiving and enslaving you. Even though words can be used to create magic spells to control your mind, if you become aware of their powers and how they are being used to control you, they cannot affect your mind as much. For example, when a magician does a magic trick, the magician can fool you into believing that the trick is real. But if you figure out how the trick is done, you can no longer be fooled because you know it is an illusion. In other words, you have become aware of how the trick works and therefore it cannot deceive you anymore. Other ways to protect your mind from magic spells are by overcoming your fears and increasing your frequency. The magic trick example that I just told you about is similar to how the dark magicians are using magic spells to control your mind. Once you become aware of how the dark magicians are using magic spells to control you, their magic spells lose their effects. Your awareness is one of the most powerful spiritual powers that you have. Learn how to use it wisely and the dark magicians will not be able to control and deceive you. The court and banking process. When you go to court for a trial in the USA, you are not really going to court but are going to a game arena where they are planning to con you using legal words and trickery. Where do you go when you want to play basketball, volleyball, or tennis? You go to a basketball, volleyball, or tennis court. Therefore, a court is where you go to when you want to play a game. They did not name the place where you go to trial a courtroom by accident. One of the words that they like to use to trick you to give up your natural rights in court is contract. The word contract comes from Old French contract and Latin contractus. contract is a very powerful thing because it can be used to trick you to give up some of the power of your free will. It can also be used to bind you to certain terms and conditions, and therefore limiting your choices and demanding you to do something to satisfy those terms and conditions. Most of us know that a contract is an agreement between at least two parties. This definition of the word contract only shows you the overt meaning. To find the covert meaning of the word contract, you need to look below its surface, dissect its layers, find its origins, and look at it from many different angles. This means that you may need to use an etymology dictionary to find the origins of the word, and split and rearrange the word using the art of anagram. One of the first steps to finding the deeper meaning of the word contract is to separate it into two words. When you separate contract in half, you get contract. As a verb, the word con is defined as to swindle or trick. As a noun, the word tract is defined as a brief treatise or pamphlet for general distribution. Based on the two definitions, when you put con and tract together, you get a deceptive treatise or a treatise of trickery. When you sign a contract with a corporation, i.e. bank, government agency, you are agreeing to a fraudulent and deceptive treatise. The good news is that pretty much all contracts you made with corporations and government agencies are fraudulent since they do not come with full disclosure. For a contract to be valid, it needs to have an agreement with mutual understanding, competent parties, and full disclosure of material facts. Another word they like to use to deceive you in court is the word understand. When you go to court and the judge asks you the question, "Do you understand the charges?" you should think twice before answering the question. If you answer yes, you are basically admitting to the court that it has jurisdiction over you. When you split the word understand into two words, you get understand. To find the hidden meaning of understand, you need to flip the two words around. When you do this, the two words in the phrase understand become stand under. This means that you basically just told the judge that you stand under the charges. One of the most common words they like to use to trick you in court is the word person. The word person is a general word for the reason that it can mean a legal person, a natural person, a corporation, a name, or any fictitious entity. Most of the time when the judge asks you for your legal name, he is asking for the legal person that represents you, which is a corporation. A corporation is a corpo ration or corpso ration. You are considered a corpse to be used as a ration to feed the systems of the dark forces. Remember what I said earlier that the federal government sees you as a legally dead person because you are considered lost at sea. The courts in the USA and the courts in countries that are operating under admiralty, maritime law are fictional courts. This is why the laws of these courts are called acts and statutes. As a verb, the word act is defined as to perform as an actor. The so-called authorities in a courtroom are actors who are acting in a play. Whether they realize it or not, they are still just actors playing a game to con you. Even though it is just a game, it is a very serious game because you could end up going to jail. The court has to operate as a game, because it is dealing with fictional things. When you get a summon to appear in court, the court is not summoning you, the body made of flesh and blood. Instead, it is summoning the legal person or the legal name that is used by the government to identify you. This legal person is a fictitious entity, just like the government. However, if you agree to act in the capacity of the legal person, you are basically telling the court that you want to be in the play called the legal system. This is why the court system is all based on presumption when it is dealing with the government and the legal person. At the deepest level, this con game created by the dark forces is a very sick and evil game to trick you to give up your energy and natural rights. This is why before they can summon you to go to court, you need to be charged first. When it comes to the legal and commerce system, the words charge, battery, and currency play a very big role in keeping the con game of the dark forces going. In legal term, when someone gets beaten up, that person is often referred to as a victim of battery. If the victim knows who committed the crime and press charges, the person who committed the battery will be summoned to go to court to face the charges. In business, when a company outsells or outperforms its competitors, one of the common words used to describe this process is beat. When the suffix "ing" is added to the word beat, it becomes the word beating. Hence, Company A is beating Company B in sales. The game of business or commerce is a game of battery, and therefore one business team or many business teams will eventually get beaten by the winner. Sports are also games of battery. In baseball, the combination of the pitcher and the catcher is called the battery. One of Dictionary.com's definitions of the word battery is the pitcher and catcher considered as a unit. Have you ever heard someone said, batter up, in baseball? Add the letter, y, to the word batter in the term, batter up, and you get battery up. The word battery is an important word in commerce and law, because it has to do with the process of harnessing the energy of humanity. In other words, this is one of the many methods that they use to drain your energy. This energy is then used by the controllers to charge their corporations, corpses, or dead entities, banks, and other commerce systems, so that they can keep their game of conning humanity going. Without our energy to charge their corporations and commerce systems, their con game will not have enough power to stay in business. As human beings, we are being used as batteries. This is why before we go to court, we have to be charged first. At the court hearing, the judge will read the charges and then charge them off after a verdict or judgment is made. This process is called a hearing because when you are charged with something and summoned to go to court, you are called the defendant or defendant, which is the deaf person who is a ward of the court and is about to meet his end by the judge. The phrase a ward of the court is an incompetent person or a person who is unable to care for himself, so the court must assume responsibility for his well-being. This is how the court sees you as a deaf and ignorant child who does not know the definition of words. This is why a short meeting in a courtroom is called a hearing. The court hearing is done to test your hearing and understanding of words. If you, the defendant, defendant, agree to the charges, you are basically swearing an oath to give up some of your energy to the judge, because the word ant means oath, vow, pledge, in Turkish. The judge has also swore an oath, but his oath is to the god Saturn. During the ancient times, Saturn was associated with the god of law and justice. Today, many secret societies still worship Saturn as the god of law and justice. According to Jordan Maxwell, the symbol that was used in the religious context for Saturn was the square and its symbolic color was black. This is why judges wear a black robe. Saturn was also known as the Lord of the Ring. When people get married today, they use the ring as a symbol for their marriage. What they do not realize is that the ring symbolizes the god Saturn. Another symbol for Saturn is a black cube. The sacred black cube that Muslims pilgrimage to at Mecca represents the god Saturn. The black mortarboard graduation hat that high school and college students wear when they graduate also symbolizes the god Saturn. Saturn was such an important god that today we dedicated a day for Saturn, which is known as Saturn Day or Saturday. It is right in your face. Let us go back to the court hearing process. After the judgment is made, if there is a fine or fee included in the judgment, the defendant will be ordered to pay the fine with currency. The covert meaning of the word currency has to do with the flow of energy. This is why the stored energy in a battery is called electric current or the currency of electricity. The word currency originated from the Latin word currens, the present participle of currere, which means to run. Now, why would they base the word currency on a Latin word that does not have much to do with paper money or coin? Because it is not really about the paper money or coin. Instead, it is about energy. To find out why currency is related to energy, you need to find the deeper meanings of the word currency. To do this, you need to use phonetics and separate the word currency into two words. When spoken out loud, the word currency sounds similar to currency. What does a current do in a river? It flows to the sea. What are the things that cause the current to flow? The forces of nature, i.e., gravity, and the elevation of the land. Dictionary.com defines current as something that flows, as a stream. The flowing movement of currents is what causes the freshwater in the river to flow to the sea. Once the freshwater is in the sea, it is now part of the currency, or the current of the sea. The word currency also sounds similar to current qi. In Chinese, the word qi means natural energy, life force, or energy flow. Based on these definitions, currency means the flow of energy. When you really think about it, currency is a medium for exchanging energy. When you go to work at a company, the company often pays you hourly. Every hour is recorded to make sure that you are paid for investing your time and energy into the company. After you have worked for a certain amount of time, you are given a weekly or bi-weekly paycheck, usually on Friday. Once you take your paycheck to the bank to cash it for currency, the currency now represents your time and energy. One important thing you need to know about the words bank and currency is that they are related to the word river. What does a river have on its two sides to prevent water from flowing out of it? Riverbanks. Banks are like rivers because they regulate currency. In other words, they regulate the flow of energy, just like how riverbanks regulate the flow of the energy of water. They did not combine the word river and the word banks to make the word riverbanks by accident. Currency is what the controllers of the New World Order, NWO, like to use to secretly steal your time and energy. Some of their favorite methods to use to steal your energy using currency are the tax system, the legal system, and inflation, a hidden tax on the public. The purpose for tricking you to give up your energy is so that they can give it to their demonic masters, the dark forces. Their demonic masters have been cut off from the eternal life current of the Supreme Creator, and therefore they need to feed on the energy of humanity to survive. This is why the dark forces like to order their minions, the controllers, to engineer wars. Wars create a lot of fear energy for the dark forces to feed on. When you really think about it, the demons of the dark forces are energy vampires. This is where the idea of vampires comes from. The demons of the dark forces are energy vampires, because they feed on the energy of humanity to survive, and they need your permission before they can do anything to you. Most of us are not aware of the information in this presentation, because we have relied too much on TV for information. The acronym TV stands for television or television. They are telling you a vision to brainwash you. This is why TV shows are called programs. They are using TV programs to condition your mind, so that they can control how you think. It is right in your face. The solution, turn off the TV, television and remove your consent. The Earth drama is all about the battle for your soul and energy. The movie The Matrix does a great job of analogizing how human beings are being used as batteries. Visit this link to watch a very short video clip that shows evidence of this. Great sources for learning more about word magic and the power of words. Word magic, the powers and occult definitions of words. This empowering book explores how words and magic shape and create your reality. It also teaches you how to free yourself from the earth drama and the legal system. A good portion of the information in this seminar was made possible by studying the works of these brave people. Great sources for learning more about word magic and the power of words. Word magic, the powers and occult definitions of words. This empowering book explores how words and magic shape and create your reality. It also teaches you how to free yourself from the earth drama and the legal system. A good portion of the information in this seminar was made possible by studying the works of these brave people. Jordan Maxwell, Kate of Gaia, Santos Bonacci, Kyron Last, Dean Clifford, Chris aka Barnone 11970.
Setting sail to the place on the map from which no one has ever returned, drawn by the promise of the Joker and the Fool, by the light of the crosses that burn, drawn by the promise of the women and the lace and the gold and the cotton and pearls. It's the place where they keep all the darkness you need. Sail away from the light of the world on this trip, baby. You will beg tomorrow. You're gonna beg tomorrow. You will beg tomorrow. Ooh, 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 ooh. Save me from Sodom.